And I would like to invite Professor Piperidis to join me. You may even sit.
So we will sing together.
Yeah, beautiful. two tenors, not three. Just two tenors, okay. So, shall I speak in English?
No.
Okay, or you take your headphones.
But I will not speak in Croatian.
No, but you can always switch to...
It is broken today.
Yes, right. Yeah. It's all Greek to you.
Yeah, it's all Greek to me.
Okay, dobro. Dakle, o čemu je danas sve bilo riječi? Ajmo malu rekapitulaciju. Dakle, govorili smo o CEF-u, e-prevođenju i ELRC-u. Čuli smo nešto o strategijama i aktivnosti u hrvatskoj vladi za ono što se zove e-vlada. Odnosno, čuli smo dosta o otvorenim podacima, više jezičnosti i o jezičnim tehnologijama. Dobili smo, ja bih rekao, čak i ne toliko kratak prikaz pravnog okvira za dijeljenje podataka iz javnog sektora, dakle ovo što se zove direktiva PSI. Također smo čuli vrlo iscrpno o vrstama podataka koje su nam potrebni i kako ih se može podijeliti kroz ELRC repozitorij. Odnosno, čuli smo kako vam ELRC može pomoći pri pronalaženju, obradi, distribuciji, dijeljenju i isporuci podataka za koje možda se nadate ili sumnjate ili ste sigurni da ih posjedujete, da ih imate i da su vam dostupni. Dakle, o tome je bilo danas riječi. Što ćemo ponijeti s ove radionice doma? Pa onda kad nemate ništa pametnije prije spavanja počet o tome razmišljati, recimo, onim lucidnim trenucima, ali kako se to zove, lucida intervala. Dakle, CEF-ovo usluga e-prevođenja će omogućiti više jezičnost u javnim mrežnim uslugama. Kako za tijela javne uprave, dakle, gdje imate mrežno korisničko sučelje za ljude korisnike, tako i za sustave, odnosno gdje ćemo imati mogućnost automatskog prevođenja za potrebe integracije digitalnih usluga upravo putem ovih programskih sučelja, aplikacijskih programskih sučelja. Dakle, vaše potrebe i vaši podaci će pomoći sustavu za e-prevođenje. Što ćemo još ponijeti? Većina tekstova koje proizvodi javni sektor su zapravo javno dostupni otvoreni podaci. Čuli smo danas, evo ja sam prvi puta čuo za otvorenu dozvolu, gospođa Bevandić je to spomenula. Ja ne znam koliko dugo to postoji u Hrvatskoj, sigurno prije 2,5 godine kad smo imali prvu radionicu, o tome uopće nije bilo riječi, o tome nismo znali ništa. Ja mislim da se to dogodilo u međuvremenu. Dakle, dijelite vaše podatke, višejezične zbirke, terminologije, čak i velike jednojezične zbirke sa sustavom za e-prevođenje putem repozitorija, ELRC repozitorija kojeg smo upoznali. Nemojte se ustručavati za tražiti pomoć. Tehničku i pravnu pomoć možete dobiti izravno od ELRC-a, možete čak dobiti pomoć stručnjaka iz ELRC-a na licu mjesta, dakle, kod vas, na vašim strojevima, na vašim računalima. Vidjeli ste kako su u stanju doletjeti padobranom Fausta Vrančića, jedno što ne znaju da je Faust Vrančić izmislio padobran. Da je padobran naša izmišljotina, naša Hrvatska. Dakle, pitajte ELRC za pomoć, recite drugima, podijelite te obavijesti i dijelite s drugima, evo, ova je oznaka za dijeljenje putem svih mogućih društvenih mreža. I zašto bismo se morali uključiti? Dakle, bez obzira na to jeste li nekako tijelo nacionalne vlasti, regionalne, ili ste jednostavno državljanin neke od država članica, možete pristupati svim tim uslugama na vašem vlastitom jeziku. Dakle, ne morate se mučiti, vidjeli smo onaj primjer iz NLEX-a, ne morate se mučiti, ne morate, često ne morate niti znati specifične termine na nekom drugom jeziku, ma koliko god vješti u tom jeziku bili. Podsjećamo, vaše mišljenje i iskustvo je važno ELRC-u, ispunite anketne listiće, odnosno upitnike i one obrasce koje ste dobili. Predajte ih tamo na izlazu, ako već niste, onda ćete tek dobiti potvrdu o sudjelovanju. Dakle, quid pro quo. Now it's your turn.
Yeah. I think you said almost everything. I'm pretty certain that what Marco said covers the essence. Just three topics I would like to stress, because I believe that all three were somehow touched upon. There was a very nice question in the first session talking about coordination between the different bodies and initiatives in Europe. It is true. Today we've heard about ELRC, we've heard about its instrument, which is ELRC Share, and this is one thing. We've also heard about Marcel, NECTM, eTermBank, and there are many other names. And these are names of projects that in the European jargon, they are called generic services projects. Now, all these projects generate either data sets, very useful for translation, or tools and technologies, again, very useful for translation. I would like to assure you that all these will end up and do end up in ELRC Share. So ELRC Share, at the end of the day, will be the one big thing that hosts or connects to almost everything that has been generated under the CF umbrella. Now, okay, and what is the relation between ELRC Share and all the other things that come under the rubric data portals, open data portals, European open data portals, European data portals, and all these things? What we've done is that we have secured that all the openly licensed data from ELRC Share end up in the European Open Data Portal. So the reason I'm saying this is because I want to assure you that we are not creating any island of information here. On the contrary, we are adding value to existing data and we're connecting this data or the outlets of this data to other data and other outlets of data. And why this? Simply because AI, machine learning, big data, data analytics are terms that are heard with ever higher frequency on a daily basis. Okay, so these are things that we will be dealing with for the next X years, where X is for sure larger than
us.
Than us, yeah. Right. That's one thing. The second thing is quality. It is true. I mean, I really liked, I do appreciate the comment that you made about quality. There are two things. Quality is important. There was a very nice talk by a guy from Google, but also, I mean, all the GAFAM, the Google, Amazon, Facebook, Apple, Microsoft, and maybe there will be other letters that will be added to it. They all say how important quality is. It is true. However, algorithms are somehow robust to few mistakes, but few is underlined and somehow bold. Meaning that if you do know that the translated data are of lower quality, then okay, please do consistently and diligently mark it as low quality. But then this leads me to something that has been popping up in several discussions, and just to keep it very, very short, there is difference between low quality translation and alternative translations, right? Translation, as almost all other creative linguistic tasks or creative language tasks, do not come with a gold solution. So there is no gold translation. There are many different ways in which we could translate something from Croatian into English, all equally acceptable. And we would like to have all these equally acceptable ways of translating. Okay? This is to be differentiated from erroneous data. Or if you want, consciously erroneous data. Right? So this was the second, but now I believe that I forgot my third topic. If it comes, I will let Marco know and he will communicate it to you. Right. This is all on my side. But before leaving this podium, I would like to wholeheartedly thank Marko Tadić for organizing this workshop so professionally, so successfully. I think it is your presence now with almost an hour delay proves that it has been rather interesting, not only for us, but for you as well, okay, gathering. I would like to thank Matea for all the help and all the support. And I would like to thank the hosts here, the European Commission, Marina Petric, correct? Correct. And the head of the representation. And of course, this comes from the bottom of my heart, thanks to the interpreters. Without you, for us today, it would have been hell. For sure, because our Croatian is broken, both mine and Maria's and Miha's. Okay, so thank you very much. See you next time.
Thank you.
I ovime zapravo zatvaramo ovu radionicu. Očekujemo vaše povratne informacije i obratite nam se. Kad god imate pitanje, kad god imate nešto za donirati, govorimo o jezičnim resursima, obratite nam se. Hvala vam još jednom.